And table flipping is much easier with a gamepad.
Yep.
Yeah, I tried using the gamepad, but it just didn't feel good. I didn't like it that much. I don't know, there's something wrong about I'm gonna say twin stick shooters, but this really isn't a twin stick shooter. There's just something that doesn't feel right about using a controller, in my opinion. Not with this game. It works great with Binding of Isaac, because you're only shooting the cardinal directions normally. And you don't have to worry about... I mean, reflexes are important, but only up to a point. After a certain point, it's like, knowing patterns and stuff. Whereas this game, yeah, patterns are important, but you really need to know your timings more than anything else. Because some of those gaps can only be made by, like, a sliver. And it's a mess. And it's a lot easier to do that when you right-click to dodge. That's part of the reason why I didn't want to do the controller, because there's no way to get, like, a dodge key set up that didn't feel sluggish to me. There's actually a lot more of these guys than I thought there would be.
Oh, well.
Yeah, so I've been dehydrated for most of the day, just because I've been recording just so much Banner Saga. Let's see. I've been recording so much Banner Saga that, you know, I'm getting, let's see, you know, kind of this cotton-mouthy effect. But now I've, you know, been drinking more water and milk and whatnot to counteract that. So, I've got cotton mouth, but I'm salivating really hard and it feels weird. Okay. Yep. Yeah, so health does scale on the second floor. Yep, you're right. It was just messing with my head or something. Okay. So yeah, there's no reason to ever take that shortcut. Maybe it's worth it. If you get items or something, but I don't think it's really worthwhile normally. Speaking of... come on, why did I do that? Speaking of, if you guys haven't actually seen my, my Banner Saga run, that was actually, like, really fun. I was kind of impressed. I'd never played Banner Saga before, just because I'd never had the time to think about it. I probably should have saved that for picking up after the... Oh, getting stuck in a water barrel. It's like the only physical thing in this game sometimes. Well, this is redundant. And dangerous. There we go. But, yeah, I just never played it before. Ooh. Breathe deep. I think that makes it so I don't take poison damage. Which sucks a bit. Yeah, prevents poison damage. Thought it gave one armor, too, but no dice. Well, that'll be useful against the Hydra, at the very least. But yeah, I never picked up the Banner Saga just because I didn't have time or something. I think it's mostly just a time issue. That's usually the case with, like, older indie games that came out when I wasn't really into YouTube that much. I actually don't know when Banner Saga came out, but the developers literally just cold-called me, effectively, being like, hey, play our game, and I'm like, oh, alright, why not? And so I decided to go with the truly insane route and play through all of Banner Saga 1 in a single day. That was awesome. And a lot of work, actually. I had a lot of fun with that. Okay, there's, like, dick all here. It's weird. Okay, let's go back this way. We haven't taken any damage. But we'll go around... I'd like to get a gun here. We might not, though. It's kind of a shame. Yeah, I shouldn't have picked up that armor. We could have gotten other stuff. Oh, it's this guy. Sure. Nice thing is you can kind of just strafe these guys. Take out the grenade. Oh, fuck. Did not see the ghost show up. He didn't spawn normally, I think. And it messed with my head. Ah, that's okay. Shortcuts 3 to 5 actually give you items. Okay, that's good to know. Okay, so let's take out the shotgunners first. I don't know if it's worthwhile, but you can kind of, you can just circle strafe around these guys pretty easily. They're very predictable. Or you could just not. But I think that, yeah, the circle strafe is totally worthwhile. It messes with their head like nothing else. They don't know what to do with it. They don't know what to do with it, with me. Okay. So we get health, which is mostly useless, and bullet time. Let's see. Okay, I can't see chat. Give me a second. There we go. Let's see. No crazier than beating Titan Souls in a single night. Oh yeah, absolutely. Let's go with bullet time. The ammo drop is nice, but it's not that useful. Christ, there's a lot of HP. Okay, so I haven't done this before. Interesting. I don't think I have a whole lot of interest in bullet time. However, it's already gone. Yep. I was hoping we'd have a little bit more time there. But no dice. And no chest. Well, let's blow it up. Worst comes to resell it. We can't sell all of these HP pickups. Alright. Fine. I guess we're going into this one with a bad use item. And a passive. And a pistol. Wow, we have nothing going into this fight. That's okay. It's the Bullet King. I'm actually fairly good at fighting him at this point. You fight a guy long enough. I think I had to fight him like 6 or 7 times in a row. Which, like, this shit gets ingrained in your head. It's actually kind of great. Because then you don't have to worry about it anymore. I really wish you could set him on fire, though. Like, that would actually help a lot. Just in terms of making this, like, a lot easier to deal with. God damn. I was too close. I was... Yeah. Okay, there are definitely some benefits to using a controller. That was one of them. I couldn't quite feather myself into the safe spot there. Oh, that's okay. We've got a stupid amount of HP. To make up for these things. I really do wish, though... Yeah. Okay, that was not great. Probably should have just used a blank. I guess I just don't give a shit at this point because we're getting, we're getting so many health pickups after this boss fight that it doesn't matter. But I really wish this game followed the Binding of Isaac, style, where the only reason, you'd, like, lose the special reward from the boss is if you actually took, red heart damage. Or, in this case, red bullet damage. I don't know. Anyway. So let's see. What do we want to do? Nothing else. Okay. I don't know what this gun does. Let's see. Missing HUD too. I don't know. Oh, shit. I'm not full health. Let's go make sure we're full health. The thing with, like, getting back into Isaac is I know I wouldn't do it for very long. As with, like, most games that I used to play a ton of, and, like, not anymore, as much as I love, like, you know, certain games along the way, I would much rather just kind of move on. So Isaac was fun. Isaac was a lot of fun. It made, like, a great race game. But at this point, it kind of lost its luster, and, like, you know, not a whole lot of people actually cared. I don't even know what this gun does. We'll find out. It kind of looks like I'm just carrying around, like, a coffee can. Sniper rifle. I think they just killed themselves. That's kind of great, actually. There he goes. This is actually a pretty good weapon. Got a bit of a spread on it. But I can make that work. Okay. But yeah... Isaac gets a little old after a few hundred runs. Yeah, the one thing this game doesn't do that Isaac always did great was, like, absolute breaker runs. I haven't seen or heard of... Oh, it's the Hegemony rifle. Okay. Yeah, Binding of Isaac did really, like, fun RNG-based, like, crazy runs well. I have yet to see, like, good synergy yet in this game. Hegemony rifle, ain't bad. Like, I actually like this quite a fair bit. honestly. Okay. So we're doing alright and haven't taken damage yet. Other than Light is in a constant state of playing Binding of Isaac. Yep. Okay, that didn't work. I backed into it, unfortunately. Well, at least it cleared the shots, but not great. Yeah, Northern Lion being, like, the premier Binding of Isaac guy is actually part of the reason why, like, I kind of lost interest in it. Because it's not that I'm, like, better or worse than him. In fact, I think I stack up okay. 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 We'll go here. God, I suck at this one. Oh, there's one. There's two. Oh, damn. Okay. What if we try, like, a really shallow angle? Nope. Okay, that was almost cool. You can have this. Well, I'll get better at that one. Hey, we get shades. Bright sunglasses. Bright future. Let's see what this one does. Slows down time during explosions. Increases dodge power during explosions. Huh. That's cool. Snaps is still doing 3 runs a day. Bleh. I don't know. I like Binding of Isaac, but like, The real Binding of Isaac YouTubers played it way more than I ever did. And as such, it kind of, like, takes the wind out of the sails, because, like, there's a lot of... I really wish the sunglasses would actually show up on my character model. Okay, there's the pole holster. Okay. I was really hoping I could... Oh, perfect. I was really hoping I could redirect them into him or something. I've always wanted to do that, but no dice. Okay, so we need to clear some space here. Okay. That was a bad time for a reload. Okay, luckily I can kind of make the holster work. We've always got another... There we go. Wait, what? Okay, there we go. That was a tighter situation than I wanted it to be. So here's the problem. We're almost out of shots. And we're out of... Oh, it's pea shooter time. Wait, pea shooter actually worked better. What the hell? Got him. Whew. Synergy with this boss. I'm actually pretty good at fighting the bolster. He's got a very understandable and easy to work with pattern. Oh, what? That actually did damage to me. What, can I, like... Okay, can't just walk into him either. Sunglasses are cool, though. But, yeah, gotta feel bad for a Northern Lion, because you'd have to imagine after a certain point he's gonna get bored of it. I mean, okay, so there's a couple of things about Northern Lion. He would not still be playing Binding of Isaac if he didn't love it. It is definitely, like, his main show, and, like, I can totally understand why he plays it, you know, mercilessly, effectively. But, like, here's the thing about Northern Lion. He's not a bad YouTuber. Like, he's actually probably one of the best YouTubers I have ever listened to. I just got bored with his content because it was infinitely cyclical. And therefore boring to me. I say as I play a ton of infinitely cyclical games. I also just, you know, don't watch YouTubers, though he was one of the two that I watched for the longest time. I don't know, do you count the Game Grumps as one YouTuber or two? I don't know. I really like his content. I really like his personality. I really like his voice and whatnot. He was actually, I'm not going to say a mentor, because technically I had, like, no real interaction with him. Probably should have saved the armor for after the level, as I'm wont to waste. But still, close enough. I play cyclical games and JRPGs. I mean, I play indie games in general, but I do play a lot of cyclical games just because they're kind of relaxing and whatnot. Well, never know what you might get. Heart piece. Eh, it works. Okay, let's go this direction. But like the thing is, if Northern Lion just decided to go cold turkey on Binding of Isaac, it would probably offend some people. It would probably piss a number of his like hardcore audience off. But like, dude could and would survive. The reason why he hasn't switched away from Binding of Isaac yet is because it's an amazing cash cow. He's damn good at it, and presumably he still likes the game. However, I will agree. I do feel bad for Minecraft Let's Players and stuff. But yeah, So the reason why I say like Northern Lion mentor whatever nonsense is the dude literally was like all over the place on Shock Rifle's not bad. I got a lot of money. I might consider it. He was all over the place on the Let's Play subreddit for a very long time. And so as such, more or less, all of the stuff I learned about YouTubing, I pretty much learned from him. Okay, we get the Mega Dazzer. I actually like the Mega Dazzer a fair amount. Okay, there's nothing left here. Let's get out. But yeah, so I owe Northern Lion a fair amount just in terms of, like, you know, I learned from his advice, which is cool. Grab Table Tech Sight. What does Table Tech Sight do anyway, come to think of it? Flip Multiplier. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, so when we flip a table, it doubles our shots. Sorry, I thought that gave us a red dot sight or something after we flip a table. This is way better. Yeah, Mega Dazzer plus bouncing is OP. Oh, yeah, it is. You know what is also OP? Water. So Minecraft Let's Playing isn't that bad because of the mods and stuff. So, you're not wrong that mods definitely keep Minecraft interesting. I'm just gonna use the Hand of Fire. It's useless against bosses. Honestly, pretty useless against most of these guys. Let's flip a table. Okay. It's awesome, but it's not. I don't know how to describe it, but yeah, table tech. Okay, I'm gonna wait for that to happen. We're gonna do that. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be flipping more tables today, but not because we're like hiding behind them, but because that bonus, it broken. Okay. I can drop them on their ass too. Let's recharge the hegemony carbine. That thing's awesome. Okay, so the reason why I feel bad for Minecraft YouTubers is specifically because if they ever want to change, their audience pretty much doesn't let them. It's hard for it to work. I'm looking at, like, okay, so CNanners is probably a good example of a Minecraft YouTuber that did actually switch pretty well and, you know, not run into too many issues because of it. The guy, you know, used to do quite a fair amount of Minecraft stuff with his friends. But then they all pretty much went cold turkey. Luckily, Gary's mod quickly became kind of a perfect stand-in for that. Don't have the hegemony rifle. I did, I just didn't have any ammo for it. Well, that was awesome. I'm not gonna be using this thing that much. But it's really fun to just send somebody flying off-screen. And just wail on them with fire and stuff. Yeah, Table Tech Sight is a lot better than I remember. I have trouble specifically putting together which ones are good and which ones aren't. But, oh shoot, what was it? I don't remember the YouTuber. I hang out with like Blitzkriegsler and Dragas and company in a Skype chat, and we discuss these things with some level of regularity. Isn't, like, Entax supposed to be, like, a Minecraft YouTuber? No, I think I'm misremembering that. I don't know. I haven't looked at his stuff yet. But so we frequently will, like, talk about Minecraft and like other like YouTube trends. So specifically, Scrap Mechanic was a huge thing for a while. Everybody from that group did Slime Rancher. In fact, I think it made C-Top's channel. That and Scrap Mechanic, which I'm a little jealous about, because I found out about them first, and I was lazy and didn't take them up. Let's see. Yeah, some people still do great with Minecraft. I'm not going to deny that. The thing is, like, Minecraft at this point is, like, terrible for most new channels. Which is part of the reason why maybe it's easy to be dismissive of them. But it truly is also such a, like, niche thing. That generally it's hard to switch away. There are no tables for me to use and abuse here. Generally it's almost impossible to switch away without kind of screwing yourself. What is it? Like, the Yogg's cast has been switching, which is good. But then again, they've always been kind of a content that, like, moves around and stuff. Because they started with World of Warcraft, of all things. What are they? Minecraft. Minecraft. If you look at a lot of the Minecrackers, most of their channels have been in the decline for, like, a very long time. And, like, occasionally you will definitely see them, stumble on something new and kind of, like, separate out. But for the most part, like, you know, some of that stuff has dropped off. And I think it's also just one of those, you can only keep up, like, any game for a certain amount of time. Despite the fact that, like, Vigante was really good for my, despite the fact that, like, Vigante was amazing for my channel, I just could not handle playing Vigante for, you know, years and years. Like, I could never Northern Lion it. The game did not have enough variety, and honestly, it was poorly balanced. Same thing with, like, well, I guess Rarquaza only did, like, 150 episodes of, Risk of Rain, come to think of it. I don't know, I don't remember that much. Let's see, so we get ammo. I don't mind the Molotov or the knife shield. So I want to say that either or both are bad, quote-unquote. I don't remember, we'll think about that one. Okay, well, let's get back up here. But yeah, so I feel bad for Minecraft YouTubers, because it's simply just a very hard thing to move away from. Usually your audience, I'm not going to say eats you alive, but they generally just, like, ignore you. Is Vigante ever going to be finished? I hope so. I'd love to play it again. I'd love to get the guys together for another night of... for another night of multiplayer. That was actually rather fun. Okay. You get out of my way. We'll flip again. Fuck. I can't believe we didn't take damage from any of that. That worked out. Okay. There have been tables of flips. Tables flipped aplenty. We're almost out of ammo for this thing. But I'm kind of okay with that. Okay, this is probably a bad thing. Crap. I don't like how frenetic this guy is. I actually really wish tables would burn. I think that would be kind of a neat thing. Okay, so we've got one more table that's flippable. But it also doesn't matter. Okay. Let's see. So we don't have anything. But yeah, no, I'd love for them to finish Vigante. And I will definitely go back to it. I know they added, like, new levels and stuff. It's just a matter of, like, it's so hard to go back to something that only changes so much between a certain period of time. Like, that is a game you can easily burn out on. Especially if you don't play it for a while and you're like, God, I suck at this now. I kind of wish when the enemies flip tables, it would get me the table flip effect. Oh! Fuck. Whatever, we got health lying around and stuff. Let's see, I'm trying to think of other games that specifically, like... I don't know. Don't do well. I don't know. Crap. Go for the red one, because trying to roll towards the blue never works. Okay, let's just keep going. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. YouTube is such, like, a weird, flexible thing anyway that... I mean, in, like, 3 years, most people are gonna probably not even remember the days of Minecraft YouTubers. Like, it's weird to think of, but, like, YouTube's only been around... Okay, so since, like, 2006, but, like, Let's Plays on YouTube have only been around since 2009, and even then, it wasn't really popularized until 2011, 2012-ish. Let's see, so we've got two locked chests. Let's go see if I can buy any keys. Okay, we can buy one. I'll take it. Let's go to this one, I guess. I don't know what the difference is between... Hello! I like the skull splitter. Okay, and let's go blow up the other one, just because we can. Let's see. But yeah, so technically, it's what, 2016? I guess Let's Plays have been around for, like, 5 years now. At least popularized Let's Plays. Wow, that one exploded. Okay. It's a good idea. I didn't sit next to it then. Let's get out of here. I assume I could increase my ammo. Like, I could refill my ammo on the Hand of Fire, but I don't think that's really worthwhile. Let's see. Okay. So we've got the Treadnought again. That's actually rather useful. The fact that he makes things explode with some level of regularity, though. Damn. Took that one on the chin. Got stuck. Didn't realize. Okay, so he still summons his dumb little dudes. I wonder if they unnerfed him slightly after people said he was too easy. Interesting question. I don't know. No, it does feel like he's a lot easier. Is he slower? Like, that's the weird part about the Treadnought. I don't entirely know what they nerfed about him. But they nerfed him. And he feels easier. Less health, I think. I'm getting a little sick of his dumb dudes, though. Okay, fine. Okay, let's just use this. Get that out of there. Damn. This is not a weak weapon. Come on. Alright, we are dying. This is, okay, weaker than I thought it was going to be. I think he gets more aggressive as you go along. I don't know. Hard for me to tell. I'm trying to keep my distance. But it's not working exactly the greatest. Alright, whatever. Okay, so when we get in the fray again, he's going to corner me. Okay, those bombs are really confusing. There we go. His missiles travel slower and his adds no longer lead their shots. Ah, yeah, that's a good point. Alright, so we get Super Space Turtle, Hero from Space. Oh, it's a companion item! I haven't seen one of those in a while. Alright, there's nothing else here. I got some health. Let's see how cheap this is along the way. This puts out the fireplace, right? Yes. Okay, yeah, we'll buy ammo for the Hegemony, we'll buy half a heart. We've got the money for it. I'm probably going to be using the Hegemony rifle randomly, but I'm probably going to be using the Skull Splitter for after this. The Space Turtle is adorable. I like that, yeah. I've only ever found one other companion item. And it's pretty fun. Let's see. A lot of big people on YouTube say how YouTube is changing for the worse because of how YouTube content isn't about creativity. It's about repetitive stuff and drama between channels. What do I think about YouTube? Is it changing for the worse? Honestly, okay, so the drama between channels thing has always been a thing. I don't know if you guys remember the days of Reply Girls and stuff. But, like, that shit was always dramatic. Vlog channels were awful. It is becoming a popular thing again. There was kind of a drop-off for a while of, like, really dramatic channels, which I kind of appreciated. But, no, like, drama has always been a thing attached to YouTube. Like, it's pretty consistently annoying. Come on. Getting stuck in there. Oh, does this shoot through tables? It does! Holy crap, I think we found our weapon. See, copy crap, greedy bastards. Nope! Copyright crap has actually been better than it's ever been, which I am very thankful for. I don't get copyright claims on nearly as many of my videos, And, I'm glad it's staying that way. Like, I get a couple. I got one for Ratchet and Clank, but that's because of freaking Universal Pictures being like, this is in our trailer for, the movie, and I'm like, ugh. But yeah, drama between channels happens no matter what. You're always gonna get some shit that decides to, you know, ruin things. I mean, okay, I'm not gonna say this to, like, talk current politics, but if you look at, politics between, like, now and 100 years ago, things are, like, a hell of a lot more dramatic with, like, shit-slinging and insults and whatnot. And, you know, private lives stopped, weren't, like, relevant to the to the public for a while? I don't know. Weren't relevant to the case, but now, oftentimes, it feels like political campaigns are more about, you know, insulting the other candidate and, like, this is why the other person's bad as opposed to why this is why I'm good. How did I not take damage from any of that? Should have hit that coffin as it went by. Thank you, Super Space Turtle. You are amazing. Okay, but, you know, so everything gets dramatic when people realize they can get ahead on it. Not to mention, like, YouTube is such a personality-driven thing. Of course you're gonna run into... Wow, yeah, Super Space Turtle is kind of a badass. Like, YouTube is such a personality-driven non-like thing that it's very easy to, it's very easy to have so many time slows. It's kind of nonsense. I love it. That, of course, you're gonna run into, like, a fair amount of drama just because, I mean, it's... I'm gonna say it's a pretty cramped space. Everybody on top, more or less, is aware of everybody else. There's only so many large channels, and oftentimes, I mean, it's like the 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon. I am, like, 1 degree separated, from... I'm actually, like, 10 minutes away to have potentially talked to PewDiePie at one point. Which, like, in person for a game. Which would have been really interesting, but probably not my kind of, deal. But, you know, I can totally see why you get, like, feuds and stuff. Though the nastiness, I think, is a little uncalled for. Yeah, Super Space Turtle is a kick-ass kind of dude. I like him. But I don't think YouTube's actually getting worse. I think it's getting better. There's a lot of, like, things that people can gripe about, but honestly, the service has been nothing but, improved since, you know, the days of yore. You no longer need to be on a multi-channel network just to survive. Super Space Turtle, just keep doing what you're doing, man. Never change. Okay, so we get the hero guy. That was worth it. He always gives good stuff. Has a base gun, is immune to damage, so hide in a corner, let the turtle kill everyone. I mean, it could, but where's the fun in that? What? Oh, spikes, fuck. Okay. Wow. I not once, but twice braved the spike floor, and we made it work. Okay, so that's good. That's a gun muncher. We can potentially get something out of it. Nastiness is human nature. We are shit. And always were. Yeah, sorta. Unfortunately, the problem is, like, there's no middle management for YouTube. Generally, when somebody wants to be a shit, they can just stay a shit as long as they want to be a shit. Which is kind of hard, to work with. Sometimes it's networks. Fuck. Yeah, problem is Super Space Turtle only kills things at certain speed. It's super powerful, but still. Let's see, what's this? Jolter. Jolter was okay. I'm gonna buy the full heart, though. Probably a key. I'll think about the Jolter. It's Foxy. Haven't seen you in a while. But yeah, so there's no middle management on YouTube. There's no HR. There's pretty much YouTube, which is this, like, kind of stupid monolithic, monolithic company that, like, I'm gonna say virtually has no interest in managing its employee. Fuck. Yeah. Okay, that was lucky. That worked out great. What is this, QA session? Any roguelike in which I play eventually becomes QA time just because, I get good enough that I don't need to focus on the gameplay and then I just talk about shit. I mean, take a look at Cavern Kings. It's, like, about the same thing. This one requires a little bit more thought and concentration. But not much, honestly. Okay, but, so, I guess there is multi-channel networks. They are kind of middle management and stuff. But, like, the problem is most of the time is they don't actually settle disputes. They're perfectly happy just raking in that ad money without touching anything. Because they really don't need to. God, do I really want to cross this? I guess I do. And we get the stinger. Hey, I'll take it. Okay, what else we got here? Something up here, at the very least. But, so, God, I need another key. We'll see if we can get that. The issue with networks, and the problem is Seaway Space Turtle only kills things at a certain speed. Yeah. No, there's a distinct problem with translation in this sort of situation. Okay, this sucks. Fuck you guys. Have skulls and a Super Space Turtle. Come on, Super Space Turtle. You win wars and shit. I like the skull, but it's just kind of redundant past a certain point. Sucks. But still, am I on floor? I'm on floor 4. No key, though, which sucks. I guess we could try fighting the boss. That might do it. Okay. Let's go this way. So, what guns do I have? We got the Hand of Flame. Honestly, let's get rid of the Hand of Flame and the Mega Dowser. Neither are particularly good. Right now, anyway. And we might be able to get something a little bit better. At the very least, get it out of my... Get out of there. Okay. So what do we get? The mailbox. Ugh. Alright. Oh, this sucks. Well, we got the Stinger. And the Hegemony Carbine. So, let's see how this goes. I don't even know who I'm up against. I've never fought this one before. Which sucks, because I have no idea what the process is for fighting it. Okay, I know what the process is for fighting it. Shoot it with the Stinger a bunch, probably. Maybe? The Kill Pillars. Alright, Hearts of Stone. Huh! What the fuck? Huh! What? What? I don't fucking know, man. Okay. Okay. Oh, shit. You know what? Clear that. Probably should have been using the Stinger again. Okay. Oh god, they're coming to stomp me. This ain't great. Okay, you know what? In retrospect...
If you can't tell, I have my head on the table. I'm taking a short break. I'll be able to beat them next time. But that was a little bit much. See, yeah, when they're in the circle spinny thing, I should have been using the Stinger. And when they're split apart, I should have been using the homie strike-through skull. But as it stood, I wasn't thinking very well, because goddamn, that sucked. The cursed, what are they called? The jammed shot sucked. Because I think that's what killed me. I don't think I took hits from any of the regular shots.
Just the jammed ones. Okay. Wow. Yeah, kill pillars is super easy with bouncy bolster eye. I'm sure.